Now I'm going to get some measurements off the chair to cut my fabric pieces. I'm going to measure across the inside back area from the cording to the edge of the cording on this side. And I'm going to add 3 inches to give myself a comfort level for pinning. I'm going to go up the back of the chair from the seat all the way around to where this piece ends in the back. And again, I'm going to add a little bit to the back measurement for cover comfort level, and I'm also going to see what I've got for available tuck area. Here I have several inches, so I'll probably add about 3 inches. I've got about 5 available, but I only need to
I'll
use
work my
three.
Way around the whole chair making these measurements and cutting my pieces.
So we're going to get our measurements to cut out these 2 pieces of fabric for our slip cover. Now this piece, you'll need a straight piece of fabric. It's a strip, and you don't want to accidentally go like this and say 5 inches, because that won't give you enough. If you draw an imaginary line from straight down here, that's about how wide that piece is going to be, because you want it to be on the straight of grain. So if you only cut it that narrow, you'd end up having it off kilter, which would make it not straight of grain. So you want to give yourself plenty of room on the left, draw your imaginary line down, which here is about 8 inches, so I would go about 9.5 just to make sure I have more than enough. And then get your height the regular way, give yourself a little bit at the bottom for extra, and then go up to the top above this point. So I'd cut it about 24.5 inches high. Now this piece, you don't have to cut that shape out of, because we're going to take a strip of fabric and we're going to take it and wrap it up, and we're going to make little pleats like are in this chair originally to wrap it around that curve. So that one, you'll get your measurement from the widest point, which would be the outside curve. Come up and around. So I would cut that piece about 40 inches. And then get my width, give myself 1 inch on either side. So I'll cut it about 4.5 inches wide. And then you also are going to add your contrast cording. Where you see cording here, we'll have our contrast of our sassy green.
Skirts.
And again, you want to add your seam allowance at the bottom and enough for staple line or the sew line at the top for your seam allowance as well. And we also want to make sure that we keep this detail in the slip cover so that you don't lose the chair's details. So we'll also get these pieces measured. Now the back skirt. And again, this has the flap details back here as well. So now we have our inside back, and we've measured our outside back. We've got the panel area measured. We're going to need 2 per chair. And I've also got all my deck pieces measured, so we'll have the mitered corners in the slipcover the same as they have on this. And then there is a cushion that goes on top of this as well. I'm getting my pieces all ready to start pin fitting the slipcover. And we're going to pin fit the slipcover in reverse, so we'll be pin fitting it right side down. And I'll pin right along the line that I'm going to eventually stitch on. And also when you're doing this, you want to make sure that this part's below your stitch line for your skirt. Which it is. That's my cording in there. We'll move on to the inside back. And this area that you see here is your excess will become my tuck-in later when the slipcover is complete.
I've got my fabric here situated pretty much where I want it to be. So I'm going to just put a couple anchor pins back here. pieces are outside back.
So now I've got it in position. I can run my finger along and feel where the cording is, so I know I've got plenty of room for my seam allowance all the way down here. So now I'll trim some of this excess off. I'm leaving about an inch and a half at this point, and when I get my cording onto it, then I'll trim it a little bit more just in case I need to shift it again for some reason. Just putting in a couple anchor pins to hold it in place. Okay, now I'm gonna take the strip that we cut out to go around here, and I'm gonna start pinning that in place. Now, instead of fighting with all this excess fabric, I'm just going to trim away what I don't need. I know that my cording's there and my cording is here. Now I'm pinning the outside back to the rest of this. So I've got a joint here, and I know it's hard to see. This piece comes to its point. Then you've got the outside back, or the inside back rather, that comes down around and joins. And then here's your outside back, which comes up. And they all join at that point. Now we're going to address this intersection. And again, you can see that on the seat of the chair, it comes down around, and then the back also comes down and they join at a point. We've also got to remember that you've got tuck-in area that's going to be under here, so you want to leave enough fabric for that. I'll just kind of start easing the decking fabric that way. And if I can find my scissors, go over there. I'm going to cut into this, knowing that my tuck-in area is in here. And I know that because I can stick my fingers in there. In this section of the chair, I can't stick my fingers in. So there's no tuck-in necessary in this part. So I'm going to cut towards the tuck-in, which will release this and give me a little bit of ease. And then I'll just make a few snips, which will then allow that fabric to lay nicely around the corner. And then this becomes my seam allowance. Cutting off the excess. We'll do the same with the top piece from the inside back. Cut in towards my tuck-in. Ease it around the corner. Making snips to release it. Until that then lays flat. Now the two are laying nicely together, and we'll trim off all this excess once we get there. And again, your pins will become your stitch line in this case. So we're going to end up stitching your flap up to here, and then we'll follow the curve. And then we can join that whole piece with your panel. Now, when starting to sew the slipcover, you want to look at your seams and see what seams intersect other seams. And you'll want to do the seams that need to be completed first based on how they intersect. So in this, I'm going to do the front edge of my decking area prior to doing the deck. And as I go, I'll stitch each seam and then serge each seam. So now we're going to put our zipper into our slipcover. I've got a number 4.5 zipper. I've closed up the end that goes up into the top of the slipcover. And then the other end I've left open at this point, and that'll get secured when I put the skirt on so that the zipper slide can't come off the zipper. So I'm going to take the teeth of the zipper, and I'm going to ride them right along the edge of the cording so that that way when my cording is flipped over, the teeth will be hidden. It takes a few minutes to get this set up just because it's awkward hanging on. So here you can see I've got my teeth, and I'm going to ride them right along the edge of the cording like that, and then stitch in my stitch line that's already there. For this part, you do want to continue to use a cording foot versus a zipper foot in order to keep that stitch line where you need it. So here you can see I've got my teeth lined up on top of the cording, and I'll start to sew. And I hate it when that happens. Here's your zipper sewn in. We kept the teeth right up close to the cording, and we sewed along the stitch line of the cording so you don't see that. And then at the bottom, I went back and tacked it down so that this catches the teeth, so that now I don't have to worry about my zipper slide coming off. And then when I get my skirt on, it will secure it even more. Now we'll put on a skirt.